As a First Nations storyteller who is not Indigenous to this land or to this country, I would like to pay my deepest respects to the original storytellers and the custodians of the land, the First Peoples of the Kulin Nation, on whose country we meet today. I give thanks to elders past, present, and emerging, and through that extend a warm thank you and welcome to any First Nations peoples who are with us this afternoon. It is a privilege for all of us to be here today. Sovereignty was never ceded, always was, always will be Aboriginal land. I'd also like to thank everyone who made today possible, and to Libby, thank you so much for sharing. Ko matatu wa te waka, ko ohine maturawa te awa, ko te hau ki taha te monga, ko tuhoi te iwi, ko Ronald Robinson Raua, ko Georgia Ash, oku matua, ko Ayeesha Aho, no reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Kia ora te whānau, kua taimai nei tēne whā. E ai ki te whakatauki, moia te poi, moia te taiaha. That proverb at the end there means sleep with your poi, which are a dancing or entertainment instrument in Māori culture, and sleep with your taiaha, which is a stick, a weapon, a very dangerous one if used correctly. It means always be ready for anything. My name is Ayeesha Ash, and I am the Artistic Director of Blackbirds. I'm a Māori Grenadian woman, Māori tūhoe on my mum's side, and Grenadian on my dad's side. Blackbirds was founded in 2015 in response to the lack of representation and misrepresentation of women of colour in the arts. Over the course of the past 5 years, we have been very fortunate enough to create and share work that tells our stories, the stories of our families and our communities on our terms. They've ranged from stories about our beloved grandparents, stories of our hair being grabbed in the street by strangers, the time we got confused for Macy Gray or Mel B or Halle Berry, which was actually fine, I was not mad about that. But that is not the story that I'm here to share with you today. Instead, I want to tell you about a mountain and how it's made me really think about how I can know and do better as an artist and as a person. And hopefully it makes you think about a few things as well. So the first time I visited Mount Tarawera was in 2007 during a school choir competition. It was also the first time that I visited Aotearoa, New Zealand, despite it being one of my ancestral homelands. So it was a really big trip for me. And also there was a bunch of teenagers, the sulfuric smell of Rotorua, and an encounter with the New Zealand Border Patrol. And you can really imagine how wild that whole scenario was. Mount Tarawera is located in the North Island of Aotearoa, nestled within the Okataina volcanic region. It's about an hour's drive from the ever-popular tourist destination Rotorua. One of our pre-arranged group activities was to climb Mount Tarawera. I think it's important to mention here that Mount Tarawera isn't actually a mountain. It's a volcano. It's an active volcano. It last erupted around 700 years ago and is expected to erupt again any day. But yeah, let's get a bunch of teenagers up there and walk around and hope for the best. It seems legit. Despite the safety risk, which went over my head at the time, we climbed the mountain. It snowed. It was magical. It is magical. The storytelling and cultural significance that are embedded within Mount Tarawera stretch back thousands of years, generations of Māori, sacred burial grounds, battles, haka, hangi, the height of 19th century New Zealand tourism, and of course, what it's most well known for, the 1886 eruption that decimated the mountain's villages, killed 150 people, and wiped away the pink and white terraces of Mount Tarawera, which were known as the eighth wonder of the world. I didn't know any of this at the time that I climbed it. I'm sure the tour guide said something about the eruption, but I didn't understand the cultural significance. And to be honest, it was the first time I'd seen snow, so my attention was otherwise occupied. Some of my whānau, my family, who live on the other side of Tarawera, in the rolling valleys of Ruatoki, came to see my choir perform in the final competition at Rotorua. Afterwards, when we were catching up and talking, I told them of all the activities I'd been doing whilst in town. They seemed pretty stoked with most of them, smiling, nodding approvingly, asking if I knew that so-and-so from down the road was our second cousin through marriage to someone's cousin's son, until I got to the Mount Tarawera excursion. I didn't know what I'd done wrong, but in that split-second look on their faces, I knew that it was big. I'm a big fan of Maya Angelou, a huge fan of Oprah, and I'm very much obsessed with my mum. And in that moment, a phrase came to mind, something each of them had repeated to me many times, whether they knew it or not. You know, when you know better, you do better. I didn't know what I didn't know, but I knew I had to find out. So I Googled. Maybe you're thinking, why didn't you just ask your whānau straight up? Why didn't you just ask the local iwi, the local tribe? Well, I didn't do that because I knew better. It's not my whānau story to tell, and I'm not going to impose myself on the local iwi any more than I already had by unknowingly, yet rudely, climbing Tarawera. I know what it's like to be treated like the cultural version to Ask Jeeves, when people could indeed just ask Jeeves. I knew better, so I did better. What I found out astounded me. I'm not going to tell you what it is, because yes, you could absolutely Google it yourselves, or you could come and see my show, but I digress. I felt pretty sick and disappointed with myself when I got to the bottom of it all. But now that I know better, I can do better. I could take my experience with Mount Tarawera as a reminder of the importance of doing your own research and a note that we are all fallible. It didn't matter that my whānau live around the corner or that I am Māori. There was still so much that I missed because I didn't think to look. Whoever coined ignorance is bliss was truly onto something, because sometimes knowing more can really suck. The society that we live in is culturally complex, and sometimes we just don't know. There's a difference between making a mistake and purposely offending someone. I've made a lot of mistakes. I'm not proud of them, but I'm also not ashamed of them. If I hadn't put my foot in my mouth more than a couple of times, I would have put a stop to my personal, artistic, and emotional growth. I'm so thankful for the grace, kindness, and patience of people around me who have gently but firmly have guided me to my own process of understanding. And I encourage everyone here to guide the missteps of those around you with grace. Be kind, be patient. Is public humiliation or call out or cancel culture really the answer? Art has the ability to teach us all so much. Its strength comes from its subjectivity, in the potential for each and every one of us to experience art and take something completely different away from it. Sometimes we find what we think we're looking for, and sometimes we don't. And sometimes people can be a bit like that too. Sometimes art, just like people, can get absolutely trashed. But why? Simply not liking a work isn't a good enough reason to tear it to shreds. And it's the same with people. Don't get me wrong, I'm not for a second saying that there aren't some people and organizations who deserve a big, huge X on their name. I myself have called out Andrew Bolt more times than I can count. Not that he's probably aware of any of those times, but that's okay. What I'm asking is that we provide space for people to learn. You don't need to be someone's teacher, but you don't need to be their attacker either. The world we live in is not as progressive as we need it to be, but if we don't hold ourselves accountable for our capacity and ability to learn, understand, and forgive, how are we going to progress at all? For every step forward that we're taking, there is always just one asshole shoving progress back. So don't be that asshole. Know better, do better. Thank you.